god, I'm making a video. It's 9:22 a.m. Oh my god, I haven't made a video in a while. It was only last week. I gotta go to the... I'm doing my hair. But in my morning routine. Look at my face. It's not bad. The swelling went. The skin is a bit scabby. Anyway, so I'm gonna go to the electrolysis. My appointment is at 1. Oh my god, I gotta go to the electrolysis. Why am I going? Oh yeah, it's because I wanna get rid of this. I didn't sleep properly yesterday. I couldn't go to sleep, I was so anxious. I was so anxious. I'm not going to sleep. Got a movie on iTunes called My Left Foot. Yeah. I saw a bit of it. It's based on a true story, and you guys might have seen the movie. I don't know, it's just this guy who only uses foot. The idea is like, I find that so inspiring. Yeah, a lot of patience and dedication you need to have to do something like that. It's just so inspiring. It is so inspiring. And look at me, I have all my limbs and things. And, where is my patience? I think I'm too spoiled. I'm too privileged. I haven't suffered enough. That is probably why. I don't apply myself. My life has been far too easy. In some ways. Oh, in so many ways, it's been far too easy. I don't think I've suffered. I don't think I know what real hardship is. what was I thinking? I'm just taking all the hair out of these clothes. That's another thing I do. I take my top and I'll be like, where's the hair in this shit? I gotta like spend like, 5-10 minutes going through this because I wanna get all the hair from my hair. Yeah. I'm gonna prepare my veggie stew before I go out. Otherwise, I'll be too lazy, and yesterday I did not prepare my veggie stew, and my whole day was ruined because I did not prepare it. My whole mood. I had drank another coffee, coffee is so bad for me. It's like, you know, man. We all know. I'll upload this video later after I come back. I don't have to do any makeup thingy because I need that. I gotta go to the job interview on Wednesday. Oh my god. I gotta prepare. pay myself for that. Well, I'm glad I got an interview. That was nice. I better not write. I think for that, I don't know if I wrote a. I think I wrote a cover letter. Because I'm thinking to myself, maybe I shouldn't write my cover letters because my cover letters are. Suck! The people are. Oh man, this cover letter really sucks. Ugh. So maybe if I don't write my cover letter and just send in my resume, oh, okay. You're like, oh, just stop talking, stop saying anything. I need to talk to people who know how to develop a career. There has to be some way to develop a career, like steps you can take to develop a career, you know? It's not so, I need to talk to some kind of a person who knows that stuff. Like, especially, you know, I heard one of my lecturers said, you know, the local court, you can work as a voluntary, as a public defender or something like a voluntary thing. You can get work experience in the court system, you know, like, you know, when people are loitering about in the court, and you can, like, if you know your stuff, probably need to get some kind of an orientation for that. I heard one of my lecturers mention that once. I don't know, how do I get that kind of a job? How do I do this, man? I don't know. It's good because if I eat my veggies too, my hair is in good health because all of those nutrients. Oh, the nutrients! Well, another movie I got is, what is it called? It's by Michael Haneke. That guy is a good director. What is it called, a movie? It's, what is the movie called? Funny Games. Yes, I got Funny Games. It's about some kind of a, some kind of a break-in, psychological terror drama or something. Yeah, I have to take this off, but I don't want to film that because yeah, I'm not going to do that. I got the Life After Death, Notorious B.I.G. Remastered Edition album. Alright, so I'll come back later, baby. It's 11:08 a.m. So I finished preparing the veggies too. I'm just gonna go in this outfit. I haven't changed my clothes. I slept in this and I wanna go out in this. So it's just a, you know, kind of pants type of thing and jumper. I don't need to do anything. You know? I'm just gonna get electrolysis. I don't have to worry about makeup or anything. Yeah, so I finished my veggie stew, preparing it. Just called my mom up. She's coming to pick me up, I think. Hopefully. The train is at 11:36. So, yeah. Oh, there was this, someone sent a petition for this woman who wants to, right to die, and so I signed that petition and shared it on my Twitter. But so yeah, I was just thinking about that.
you know, death, and you know, because I should stop drinking coffee, because coffee is not good for me. Like, I've noticed that it really, like, it upsets my stomach, and so I don't know. So I was just thinking about, like, oh my god, what if, like, they found out that I got cancer in my, I don't know, somewhere in my bowel area, and what if I was peeing blood? And then if I found that out, that I was peeing blood and it's cancer, and my whole life would change, you know. I'll be like, you know, my whole priorities will change completely. It's like, your life is gonna be different. Plans and everything is gonna change dramatically. And it's just like how, like, you just don't know, like how the future is, like, everything seems so, like, you can't really control or predict, or I don't know, it just scared me, you know, the thought that, you know, I might get cancer or some disease. And I mean, I don't know, just, oh man, it's so depressing to think about it. But oh, my mom came, so yeah, I was thinking about that. I was like, yeah, so depressing. Honestly, all you can do is just stay as grounded and just deal with the situation. It's like, I don't know. It's like every situation, every part of life is just as challenging as every other part. It's like, even sitting in the, and making this vlog, it's like I'm thinking, will I ever find peace? Will I ever be free of worry, anxiety? Will I ever be free of that? Anyway, so I'll be going soon, and yeah, hopefully just get more of the electrolysis thing and take it from there. And, yeah. Okay. That's what I'm wearing. See, I'm not even wearing any bras, so you can sort of see my breast there, right? Yeah, sort of, but hopefully it shouldn't be too much of a thing. No, this is something. Anyway, so, right, so that's what I'm wearing. This is what I slept in this, and that's what I'm going out in. Well, I think I removed the top. This is how it looks before. See all of that stuff? It's that, this one was all swollen. It's all like, so the skin is still kind of scabby. That's why I said scabby. What do you know? I think there's no hair there. Like over here and here and here. So, I don't know. Better ask her. Is this working? What does this mean? Anyway, as I was saying about the whole, you don't know what the future is gonna bring, and I was just thinking, you know, life is, I was thinking, you can never be ready for life. You know, now's as good a time as any. One can never be prepared enough for life. Now is as good a time as any. What's this guy? Now is as good a time as any to live. I am living, but you know, like, consciously live, I guess. Yes, consciously live. Uh, Bit early. Waiting in front of the office. Man, I look so messed up. Look at that. Finished.
Not that bad.
So it's not that bad today because they put a different cream which is much more stronger. Actually, I bought it, but didn't. Yeah, so is it that bad? So so it's around 3 when we head home. So I booked another session for next Monday. Yeah, next one is at 10 a.m. So you know, I'll just keep on doing it until I can keep on doing it. Either the funds run out or get a job and earn something.